Hello, I'm Jury Root, and this is Mass Effect, continuing our adventures in side quests. And, I did something after the last video, and if you look, I have a lot of money. I sold off everything except my Mark 6 stuff, because I've already gone through the Mark 5 stuff that I have, and it's not really worth replacing anything. I got rid of all the Mark 1, 2, and 3 stuff that I'd set off, finally, and I'm almost at a million. Actually, I'm not just almost at a million.
Looking
for
supplies?
I just passed a million.
Not right now, thanks.
No problem.
Okay.
Keep checking back.
Come on. Yeah.
Looking for supplies?
Check back now.
Let's see what...
I actually did. Went ahead and sold some of my Mark 6 stuff to push me over the million mark. So I had the rich achievement. And, as a result, I can buy these. Spectre Master Gear Mark 7. And I'm actually surprised that he's able to get those. I didn't expect he would be able to get them. I thought I'd have to go back to the Citadel, but I don't. And these are good. Like, I've got a real good pistol just now. Really good pistol just now. And this is better than the pistol that I got. Now, it's expensive. It's really expensive. But man, these are worth it. What I'm going to go ahead and do is just for myself. Not too worried about my other characters. Not too worried about Garrus. Not too worried about Liara. They can pretty well handle themselves. They're AI, and aside from armor, they're great. I will actually look at this. No. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and buy the sniper rifle and the pistol. I want to buy all of them, but I want to keep my money for some other stuff, potentially. I definitely want to keep an eye out for certain types of armor that may appear that are really good. So, let's go ahead and buy the Spectre sniper rifle. Oh, accept, not buy. Wrong button. And the Spectre pistol. And now, I can switch these. And like I said before, these are just... And the wiki actually basically says it outright. These are everything that you could want cranked up to 11. They're basically the best things in the game. They're not just basically the best things in the game. They are the best things in the game. Yes, I want to transfer upgrades. Actually, I want to check these upgrades. I got kinetic stabilizers already. I've got kinetic stabilizer 6, though. Combat scent scanner 6, which I don't want that. I want stabilizer and the cooling option. And there's a type of ammo that's coming up very soon that I'm going to want instead of these. But it ramps up heat so bad. And then I've got this, which again, wow. I mean, I don't even need options with this. I don't even need upgrades for this. I've got the kinetic stabilizer 4 already installed. Let's go ahead and get the 5 installed. And I don't have anything else. I can put another kinetic stabilizer on there, but that's not really worth it. It's not really worth bothering. I don't think I even need to worry about an organic surviving a hit from this. So, yeah, that's a thing now. And now I'm back down to 500,000 credits. But again, your money is just going to ramp up, and I didn't even have to sneak anything like that. And the next thing I wondered is, does Garrus have anything to say?
What can I do for you?
Yes, he does.
Something bothering you?
It's Saren. I'm starting to wonder whether we'll ever find him. He's always one step ahead of us, and he's got those damn geth.
We're getting close, Garrus. We'll find him.
I wish I had your confidence. I just can't stand the thought of him getting away with everything he's done. I know you're doing everything you can, and if anyone can catch him, it's you, but if there's anything else I can do to help, anything, just tell me what you want me to do, and I'll do it.
I just asked this.
Thank you, Garrus. I'll keep that in mind. Just make sure you're ready to go when we do catch him.
Yes, sir. I'll be ready. Can I ask you something, Commander?
What is it?
Are you worried that the Council might be protecting Saren? I mean, they were really dragging their heels before. What if we find him, bring him back to the Citadel, and they refuse to act?
I get the feeling this isn't a question. Speak your mind, Garrus.
Well, maybe we shouldn't give them the chance, Commander. In my opinion, Saren's too dangerous to be kept alive. Too much could happen. He could escape, or the Council might let him go. If we find him, when we find him, I say we make sure we stop him permanently.
If Saren won't listen to reason, if he forces my hand, I'll kill him in a heartbeat. But only if it's absolutely necessary.
But what's the point in keeping him alive? It just gives him an opportunity to escape or convince the Council to listen to him. And what about the Geth? They might try to free him.
We know more about Saren's plans than anyone. But what do we really know? If we just kill him, we lose the chance to find out.
Yeah, I see your point. Do you really think there's more to know, other than the fact that he's a raving lunatic?
Maybe, maybe not. But it's not a chance I'm willing to take.
Yes, sir.
Also, Garrus has new armor. I found, or did I find? I guess I found a suit of Agent 6, and I had not realized it. The agent is this black and blue armor, and man, I do like it. She doesn't wear her armor on the ship. Rex doesn't wear his armor. Actually, he's the only one that actually wears his armor on the ship. So, I guess there's that. I don't know if Rex has anything to say. I don't know any... Maybe everyone has something new to say. I just thought that, hey, after Dr. Salian, maybe we need to talk to Garrus.
Commander?
Let's see what we got.
Do you have a few minutes to talk one-on-one?
I should get back to my duty, Skipper. Rifles don't maintain themselves. Not yet, anyway.
Oh my god, it's the Proto-Garrus!
I wouldn't mind talking more later, though.
Dismissed, Chief.
Sir.
Because right now, Garrus is all ready to go. But next game? Next game, he's all about them calibrations.
Shepard.
So, you'd rather be a merc than help your people?
I'm a fighter. It's what I do.
Aren't you at all worried about what will happen to the Krogan?
What the hell do you want me to do about it, Shepard? I'm tired of sticking my ass on the line and getting nothing for it.
So you're just giving up on your people?
I gave up on fighting for a lost cause. I'm not like you, Shepard. I'm no hero. Bottom line, killing for credits simplifies things.
You ever think about helping your people?
Why?
I try not to. But there's a lot of Krogan mercs out there. I'm always running into them. Half the time I'm being paid to kill them. But that's just part of the job. You don't get to pick who your enemies are.
Is that new?
How long have you been a merc?
Long enough. I took my first contract right after I left my home system. It's good work if it doesn't kill you.
I get the feeling you enjoy your work.
Sure. You get to see the galaxy on someone else's credits, and most days end with a good fight. I've tried more organized fighting, private armies and such, but it gets too messy. I fight best on my own, or in very small groups. I don't like people relying on me, and I bloody well don't like relying on them.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
Ah, Codex entry. Experience! So Dally might have something new to say, too. So I guess we're gonna go talk to everybody today. What about you?
Something I can do for you, Commander.
Carry on, Adams.
Aye, aye, Commander.
It feels like we're getting near the end, doesn't it, Shepard? With Saren, I mean.
You know, I always suspected that these conversations were tied to completing story mission bits. I think everyone did. But now that I'm playing through and pushing through all the side quest stuff and talking to them without going between the story bits, maybe it's linked to level, which seems weird. Because I haven't done the story stuff yet. I'm doing all of the side quest stuff first, and that's going to come out alongside the story stuff. So these conversations are kind of getting a little weird as far as Garrus and Tally here.
It won't be much longer. One way or another, it'll all be over soon.
It's kind of
You'll
crazy.
Find the conduit before he does. I know you will. You have to. And after this is all over, When my pilgrimage ends, and I go back to my own people, I'll be proud to say I was a part of it.
An important part. Back on the ship.
We couldn't have done this without you, Telly.
You've been good to me. A lot of people treat Quarians like second-class citizens. They just want us to go back to our fleet and disappear. But you've treated me just like everyone else on your crew. Like an equal. That means a lot, and it says something about you. Whatever happens, I just want to say thank you for that.
I'm gonna miss you when you go back to your own people, Telly.
That won't happen for a while yet. I'll be right here anytime you need me.
Okay.
I should go.
See you later.
I'm curious, do you
looking
have
for supplies?
More of them?
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
No, you don't. Okay. I know I can buy as many as I want. It's not that I only get one set. But it might not be until he restocks that I get more. Let's see if Liara or Kaden have anything to say. Chuckwuss, I know you're going to say the same things. I guess that kind of makes sense.
I get the feeling you want to ask me something, Commander.
I just wanted to talk.
Of course, Shepard. What did you want to talk about?
Probably nothing. Nothing.
I should go.
Goodbye, Shepard.
I want to talk, but I'm not going to stay. What I was looking at is these two surgical arms, or surgically looking arms. And it's like, okay, you got three beds, but you got two arms. But then the arms are between the beds, so they can probably work on people just fine in either of the beds, or any of the beds. Just those intense stares.
Anything you need, Commander?
Just trying to get a sense of where the crew's at. Thoughts?
I've wasted enough of your time for now, Commander. Okay. We'll have time for personal debriefing.
We'll talk another time, Commander.
It's interesting, this one. Sorry. It's interesting in this one that your human crew have practically nothing to say. I mean, really, practically nothing to say. You got this little side story thing with Ashley, but that's really it. Versus... Liara has some things to say. Tally has some things to say. Rex has some things to say. Garrus has a lot to say. And in the second one, third ones, they really kind of flesh that out a little bit with the loyalty missions, and everyone has something to say. It's usually pretty much limited to whenever you finish the story mission bit, though. So, right now, I'm at the Citadel. Why did I go to the Citadel? Probably just to take people outside so I can change their armor and stuff. Where was I wanting to go? Where was this that I was going? Was it Armstrong Nebula? Yes, it was. I'm going to go do these Gath bits. And while I'm doing these Gath bits, I'm taking Tally with me, which I think means I'm probably going to be taking Yara as well. Also means that, actually, at this point, I can probably finish a lot of my survey stuff, just because of I'm going to 4 star systems all at once. Well, maybe not all at once. Obviously, I'm going to be cutting this into a couple videos, but no, not cutting so much as breaking. Cobalt. Also, I found Matriarch writings on, was it here, Junthor? Let's go ahead and get in here to Rangri. I Apparently this is a, there's a rogue planetoid dubbed Vots that entered the system approximately 10,000 years ago. It's trapped in a decaying orbit around Rangri. Earthquakes and windstorms are increasingly common. Within a few hundred years, the planets will rip each other apart. Travel consortiums have already announced sponsorships of cruises to observe the spectacle. Now, remember, the Asari are a few thousand years old, or can live for a few thousand years. So it's not one of these systems, one of these. It's some other planet somewhere else. I'm not sure, that's weird. I mean, I guess it must be on the horizon. Because this involves Geth, I definitely want to take Tally. I'm going to take her, and that way... I mean, I'm not too worried about my combat strength. I believe all of these are going to be exterior combats, which means using the Mako, which means I don't need to worry about any of this. So, let's accept... Wait, what's the examine squad do? Can I do this from... No, it's... Really? That's all that is? That's useless. Oh yeah, that's the other planet, all right. Wow. Yeah. Okay. So what planet am I on? So I'm starting here. Uh-oh, apparently there's a thing right over here. Might not take long for me to get ambushed. Or nothing happened. Oh! Apparently there's a tune that plays in the background. See if I can hear it. I thought I heard something, but I was driving, so I didn't really stop and listen or anything. And this is about right there. I think I can hear anything over that wind. There's a thing over here I'm gonna go ahead and grab. I think it's supposed to be one of the, there's something that I had on one of my videos before. I don't remember if I drew attention to it or not. I'm trying to think of how to explain it now. As spaceships travel through magnetospheres through magnetic fields of planets. You see this with things like the Voyager probes and all of those probes that have gone out. As they travel through the magnetospheres of planets, and they've traveled through Venus too. Jupiter and Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, things like that. They get sounds. I don't know the exact, like, how it works. Anyway, the burnt corpse is evidently a mom-and-pop independent salvage team. Shows signs of close-range hits from Geth heavy particle beams. And there's nothing to get here. I mean, I don't know exactly how it works, but these things can trigger... Let's just go straight south from here. These can trigger... They generate sounds, basically. And when I was a kid, we actually had... my mom actually got several CDs of these recordings of the Voyager probes and some other probes as they went around different planets. And it's very spooky, but it's very ethereal and kind of relaxing in a way. I mean, you wouldn't think something so potentially spooky would be nice, but it actually is. And every once in a while, you'll hear something that sounds very similar to that. And I'm thinking that's what it's supposed to be. I could be wrong. But because of the wind, which is also probably why I'm speaking louder than usual. Okay, this I guess is where the mom and pop salvagers came from. Looks like they do have some stuff. Looks like they might have some real good stuff. I will say as well... Ooh. Okay. Savagers who made this camp are gone. They seem to have abandoned abruptly some time ago. They were killed. They were just killed. That actually does remind me, though, I do need to update equipment on Liara, because I now have a much better pistol for her. It's not as accurate as the one that she has, but it is better in a number of ways. What does she have? A rail extinction? Let's give her a kinetic stabilizer for her. And Tally? Tally, do you have anything good? You know what? I'm going to go ahead and give you that. And I like that. I'm going to go ahead and start handing out some of these weapons, because I think that's kind of one of the things that I really haven't been doing that I probably should be. Is just give them some good alternate weapons. So Tally, I'm going to go ahead and give you that, and I don't really have anything else to share. That also is a very good sync for items when you're getting loaded up on items. I should have used before, but I didn't. So I think that's what that sound is, you know, it's just a marker that, hey, you hear this sound here. Which just means it's an magnetic squeal, basically. It's interesting how some of these things move on the map. Because this was moving very, very actively versus the other thing in the background, which was not. Ooh, that was close. Polonium! And money. I'm starting to wonder how close I'm getting to on those, because I mean, I might be finishing them soon. Really? Oh, too steep. Crash escape pod. This has been here a while, I think. League of One. I'm going to check that out, actually. Let's see. No. Turing insignias. 9 of 13. Asari writing. 7 of 10. Prothean data disks, 5 of 7. Signs of battle. I have all the ID tags, or I have enough ID tags. I think there are actually more. And I have half the League of One medallions. And I'm getting pretty close on these. The gases are already over because all you can get, the only way you can get those is by So she has pistols and shotguns, so I did need to upgrade her pistol. For some reason, I always thought that she just had standard shotguns. That'll actually be extremely handy here, so I kind of wish that I'd given her more of that, but it'll be alright. Liara, you don't have anything, I don't have anything, so we're done there. Then there's stuff over this way. No. That's what I'm gonna do. That'll give me a good heading. Right, the surveyors, prospectors, scavengers. Probably set those up. Not a bad idea, honestly. I mean, you know, it's dangerous. There's cliffs. You could fall and... I don't know, I got nothing after that, because falling apparently doesn't... I mean, if you're walking, then yes, that's dangerous, but... Okay, maybe they're not all outside, but that's fine.
I'm on my way.
It's kind of creepy, actually. Actually, now that I'm thinking about it, because of the spikes outside, I'm betting we're probably dealing with husks. He's got a new shotgun. Tally can use that right away. She currently has a Firestorm 4. Tornado is more damaged by a lot. I'm just going to go ahead and keep it with the Firestorm. What else did I pick up? She's got that, and she's got that. Okay. Because that's all Liara can use. Aha! Okay, now I need mods. I sold all my mods. Actually, I should probably equip that to get with the concept of going ahead and getting those equipped. Pistol. Striker 7 pistol. Which, I'm not going to worry about mods for her yet. But, I mean, like me, I could use another mod here, but I don't have any. Tis unfortunate. There's nothing over here, nothing right there. Okay. Can definitely do some better armor. Oh god, here they come. Alright, we're good.
Clear.
Thank you. check in the room for anything good. Oh, medical kit. Ooh. No, that's useless. Oh god, they can open doors. They're at least as smart as— oh god, there's more. Interesting. Gained a level. Nope. 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 Ah, you is the character screen. I've been using I for inventory, but I have not been doing that yet. I guess I may as well commit to that first aid. And you, I'm putting on hacking. Entirely. Did I get some stuff too? Kinetic buffer. Ooh, armor connector. Okay. That's probably a good one. Oh, the doors were already open. Well, I guess that kind of makes sense. I mean, a little bit. Okay. There's a thing there. There's a thing there. Cryo rounds. I don't like cryo rounds. Not really. Medium armor human, Ursa 7. Okay, so here's the deal. I am currently wearing Scorpion 1. And I keep forgetting to up my armor. Damn it. And I can't see how it looks until I could wear it. Tactical armor, I'm gonna have to get... Oh man, it's gonna be... 1, 2, 3, 4 levels before I can get tactical armor. I need to remember to up tactical armor. Like, seriously. What level am I at? 33. Okay, I'm gonna go up more, so that's fine. Light armor. Mantis 6. How about that? That's a lot better. That's actually really good. How does it look? I'm okay with that. Yes. Okay, it's new armor. Now I just need a Mark 7 armor, but I'll take what I've got for now. That will be a huge benefit. Can I do anything with anyone else's armor? I mean, I assume that I can. She can get the Scorpion 1, which isn't really much better. And no. Okay, so I was wrong. Unfortunately, when it's a Mark 1 armor that I'm handing down, it's not really a hand-me-down. Some concrete slabs. I don't know that I do, but it certainly sounds like I move faster.
Hostile contact.
Oh god! Oh god, no! Crap! I need to kill the gas. All the way back around to get up.
first step in a long journey.
Okay, but there was still debris over there. I think the main problem is there's really no reason they had to have such steep hills. I also did miss a mineral deposit. Might be a really good armor upgrade. The exoskeleton 6 is what? Oh no, that's just the... Never mind. Just didn't bounce so much. It's not like a lot of these places have low gravity either.
On my way.
All right, and that is it. Go ahead and get moving to the other one, though. I may cut that one in half. I'm not sure. Depends on how things play out. But, I mean, really, all that there is to these is exactly what you saw. Which is pretty much the same as all the other Sidequest planets, which is why I'm doing this on the side. Kind of punny. Is there anything in this asteroid belt? It doesn't look like it. Nope, no, there is. It's hiding. Carbonaceous asteroid. League of One Medallion. Antibar is where I can land. It's a very cold place. Very cold. Survey here. Deposit of Iridium. Next planet is here. It's the wrong button. That's the back button on my mouse, not the... Okay, oh, I can survey this one. Some Mercury. That's why I called it Mercury. Okay, one more. Alright, you know what? I am actually... I'm gonna go ahead and call it at that. I'm here, I'm ready to go down. I think I can probably get the next 3 done in one episode, I hope. But this is either gonna go over by... a good 5-10 minutes, or it's going to be about right. And as a result, I'd rather go ahead and cut it, because I'm at the 40-minute mark. So I want to be somewhere between 40 and 50 minutes. And I don't know if it'll get higher than that. So I'm going to go ahead and stop here, and zoom out, and get back onto the ship. Because there's no exit for this. But anyway, not the point. Lots of experience. Oh, and lots of stuff. Do I get? No? Nothing more? Okay. But I don't have so much stuff in my inventory that I'm too worried about it. I'll go ahead and give myself a good storm 6, though. Can't rotate that, so unfortunate. So for now, as always, if you have any comments on the game, gameplay, or my own performance, do please leave a comment. If you enjoyed the video, do please like, and have a good day.